Hello everyone. So the next topic which we will be going to discuss is about the deficiency symptoms of the essential elements. So first we will understand what is the essential elements, what are the macro and the micro elements, and then we will move forward towards the deficiency symptoms of the essential elements. So let's start with the first. The essential elements has been divided into two parts, that is non-mineral elements and the mineral elements. And the mineral elements are further divided into the macronutrients and the micronutrients. So what is this is here that in case of non-mineral elements, these elements can be carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, and they are considered as non-mineral elements. Whereas in case of mineral elements, the major elements, for example, like molybdenum, nickel, copper, zinc, iron, manganese, boron, chlorine, all these consist of the mineral elements. And further, they are divided into macronutrients and the micronutrients. So, what are macronutrients and what are micronutrients? The macronutrients, they are the six essential mineral elements that are required in relatively large quantities. So this is 1000 mg per kg of the dry weight. So this is the macronutrients that are present in a large quantity. So examples are given below. For example, there are nitrogen, there is phosphorus, then potassium, calcium, magnesium and sulfur. So these are all the macronutrients. Next, what are micronutrients? As the name suggests, micro, which means these are present in very small quantities. So the examples of these can be boron, copper, iron, chloride, manganese, nickel, sodium, molybdenum and zinc. So these are the macro and the micronutrients. Now, next we will be discussing about the deficiency symptoms. So deficiency means when something is deficient in a particular element. So the elements are said to be deficient when they are present below the critical concentration. So here critical concentration means that the concentration of the essential element in the tissue below which the plant growth or yield is retarded. So this is known as the critical concentration. Now, since each element has one or more specific structural or functional role in plants, so every nutrient or every element, they have a specific or functional role to perform in a plant. So the absence of any particular element can show certain morphological changes in the plants. So these morphological changes that are inductive of deficiencies of certain elements, they are called as deficiency symptoms. So when there is something deficient in the plants, they will show through the morphological changes. So these are the deficiency symptoms. So deficiency symptoms, they are shown in plants which includes the chlorosis, necrosis, stunted plant growth, premature fall of leaves, buds, and inhibition of the cell division. So these are all the deficiency symptoms which we are talking about. So the deficiency symptoms, they vary from element to element, and they disappear when the deficient mineral nutrients is provided to the plants. So some mineral elements such as nitrogen, phosphorus, molybdenum, magnesium and potassium, they can readily move from one part of to the another part of the plant, and these are known as mobile elements. So there are two elements, that is mobile elements and immobile elements. So mobile elements are those that can readily move from one part to another, and immobile elements are those that are not able to move from one part of the plant to the another part of the plant. So they are known as immobile elements. Deficiency symptoms, they are further divided into two parts: acute deficiency and chronic deficiency. Acute deficiency is when a nutrient is suddenly or no longer available to the rapidly growing plants. And the chronic deficiency is when there is a limited but the continuous supply of nutrients at a rate that is insufficient to meet the growth demands of the plant. So this is about the acute deficiency and the chronic deficiency. Then nitrogen. If you talk about nitrogen, the mineral element in the plant they requires in the greatest amount. So nitrogen is present in the greatest amount in the plant. So it serves as a constituent of amino acids, amines, proteins, nucleic acids, nucleotides, coenzymes, hexosamines and others. So if there is a deficiency of nitrogen in the plant, then what symptoms or what morphological characters it show? It shows the chlorosis in the older leaves. It shows the leaves which are smaller than the normal and the plant growths are stunted. So this is when what happens when the nitrogen is deficient in plants. So we will be discussing about all the macro and the micronutrients here. Next we will talking about is phosphorus. So it is a component of sugar phosphates, nucleic acid, nucleotides, coenzymes, phospholipids, phytic acids, and they have a key role in the reaction which ATP is involved. So ATP is energy. When the energy is involved, these play a major role. So if a phosphorus is deficient in plants, what happens is the purple to red leaves, purple leaves get converted to red leaves. Then there is a smaller than normal leaves. The leaves are smaller in size than the normal size of the leaves. There is a limited root growth. So it basically affects the growth of the plant. There is a delayed plant maturity and fruit setting. Then characteristic symptom of a phosphorus deficiency also include the stunted growth in young plants and a dark green coloration of leaves, which contains small spots of dead tissue called the necrotic spots. So this is what happens when a phosphorus is deficient in plants. Next about the potassium. So it plays a major role in the regulation of the osmotic potential. Osmotic potential is when there is a movement of molecules from a higher concentration to a lower concentration. So this is it plays a role in the osmotic potential of the plant. Then it is required as a cofactor for more than 40 enzymes. So if a potassium is deficient in plant, it will show the chlorosis in the leaves. There is a marginal chlorosis in older leaves and poorly developed roots. Then the potassium is very mobile within the plant and deficiency symptoms constantly appear first in the older tissue. Then the next is about the calcium. So calcium, it serves as a constituent of the middle lamina of the cell walls. So it is required as a cofactor by some enzymes which is involved in the hydrolysis of ATP and the phospholipids. So if we talk about the deficiency symptoms, then the leaves distortation, blossom end rot in the tomato, brinjal fruit and tip burn in the lutus. So this is about the deficiency of calcium in plants. Next is about the magnesium. So magnesium is required by many enzymes. So it is involved in the phosphate transfer and it serves as a constituent of the chlorophyll molecule. So it plays a major role as a chlorophyll molecule, as a constituent of chlorophyll molecule. So what happens is when the magnesium is deficient in plants, there will be a chlorosis in the old leaves. First chlorosis may be intervinal. So this is what magnesium plays a role in the plant and what are the morphological changes in the plant. Then about the sulfur. So the component of cysteine and methionine and protein, so these are the components of sulfur. Then the constituent of lipoic acid and coenzyme A and many other are the constituents of sulfur. The deficiency symptom is chlorosis in the young leaves. There is elongated spindly and woody stems. So this is the deficient symptoms of the sulfur. Molybdenum is important for the oxidation reduction properties. So it is important for the oxidation reduction properties. So the deficiency symptom here is intervinal chlorosis. This is the deficiency symptom. Then the manganese. Manganese is required for the activity of some dehydrogenases, kinases and oxidases. So the deficiency symptom here is intervinal chlorosis. Then zinc, it serves as a constituent of enzymes such as alcohol dehydrogenase and many other. So the deficiency symptom here is intervinyl chlorosis. Then the next next element is boron. It is found in the cell wall, which is complex with raffinose, and in phloem complex with sorbitol. So the deficiency symptom here is stunning and distorted growth. Then if we talk about iron, it plays an important role as a constituent of cytochromes. So the iron deficiency symptoms are similar to those of MN. Okay. So this is the deficiency symptom. So in manganese also there was chlorosis of the leaves and etc. So it shows the symptoms same as that of manganese. Then what about the copper? Copper is associated with enzymes such as ascorbic acid oxidase, and the deficiency symptom of this element is plant growth is retarded and leaves may appear to be elongated. So plant growth is retarded and leaves may appear elongated. Then these are some of the references of